Hi friends, in this video we will learn how to stop and start the Jenkins instance from the command prompt. Click on Windows, search for CMD, right click on it, run as administrator, confirm yes or no, yes. Now start typing the command net start Jenkins. Okay, the Jenkins service is started. So you get the confirmation that Jenkins service was started successfully. Let's go and verify from the browser whether it is really started or is there any error. Okay, so this is our Jenkins instance URL. So I have installed it on my system, that's why I'm typing it as a local system, or you can give your IP address of the system as well, and which is it is running on the port. During the installation I have given this port, that's why I'm entering this port operated by colon. Just click on enter. Okay, our Jenkins instance came up. This is the login prompt of Jenkins. Start typing your Jenkins user ID and your password. Okay, we are able to log in successfully. This is your user, this is our user ID. Okay, I'll just say log out. Now let's see, we will try to stop this instance and verify it. Net stop Jenkins. Okay, it is getting stopped. Okay, it has stopped successfully. Let's go and verify from the browser. Just refresh this URL. Okay, it is down now because we have stopped the Jenkins instance from the command prompt. Okay, there is one more method to stop and start the Jenkins instance. So I will show that method also in this video. Let's go to the Jenkins installation directory, which is in C drive under program files. Jenkins, copy this path, come back to command prompt, cd, paste that path, just right click, press enter. You are in that path now. Do directory listing. So this is the one we need to use to stop and start the services, jenkins.exe. So copy that one, paste it. So since we have stopped it in the previous method, now I am going to start it. Jenkins.exe start. Okay, starting the service with the ID Jenkins. So let's go back to browser and verify whether it has started really or not. Come to here, just refresh the web page. See, it's coming up. So this is the second method to start the Jenkins. Let's try to stop it again. Stop. Okay, it has stopped the Jenkins instance now. Just refresh the URL again. Okay, it is stopped successfully. Suppose you don't want to stop it every time, you just have to restart it, then there is a command Jenkins.exe. First time starting it. Okay, it has started. Now one more command, Jenkins.restart. Okay, it will stop and start automatically. Instead of we stop and start twice, this command does, it will just stop and start it immediately with single command. Okay, so these are the two methods which we can use to stop and start the Jenkins instance on Windows 10 operating system.